ready to cook up some stuff, y'all. Today I'm gonna prepare, I'm gonna grill some lamb and out of fresh peppers from my garden, chop them up and roast them on a grill, as well as banana peppers, red peppers, green peppers. I'm gonna cook them up on the, roast them on the grill, chop them up, and put some lamb on there and make them real, real tasty. So right now my lamb is sautéing while I get the grill ready. So just bear with me for a second. So I'm cutting some peppers up, y'all. And the crazy part about it is I can take the seeds out and I'm gonna grow them in the house during the winter season. But I love the peppers. So let's split all these up. These are fresh off the garden. They don't get no fresher than this.
Fresh out the garden. Just making sure you're registered.
Cut the seeds out and keep them and grow some peppers in the house during the winter season. So just cutting the peppers open. Fresh roasted peppers, y'all. All the seeds out. I can use the seeds, so I'm gonna grow a ton of peppers during the fall. Cut that in half. Gonna put some olive oil on these. Put some olive oil on. Make it nice. Wow, this one don't have that much seasoning. That one ahead. Blow this a little bit so y'all can see. Yeah, one more pepper and a couple of bell pepper has plenty of seeds in it. Peppers are nice and fresh, y'all. Banana peppers. So I sauteed, I put some oil, some olive oil. I put some, I think it's sage from my garden, and I sauteed them in the, on the lambs, real nice lambs. Them simmer real slow for about 30 minutes, 20 minutes, turn them over. I like them well done. I don't like the red stuff, y'all. I like them well done, so. Right back. I'm gonna let them simmer for, probably, like I said, 25 minutes. They're kind of off the grill, so that sort of take its time and cook. And I'll be back at y'all.
Free trial now.
So I'm taking a little bit of olive oil and spreading it on the peppers. Flip them over and do the same thing. Coat them real good, the olive oil. Basically roasted peppers. Really good for you. The red ones are high in beta. betaine and also vitamin C. All of them got vitamin C, but the higher, the yellow ones and the red ones are supposed to be higher. So let them simmer a little bit more. Let's check the check the lamb, see how they do. I'm just trying them over. I want them to start sticking. Some of them cook a little bit longer. They start to stick. I turn them probably like two or three times. So they get well done. I don't like them raw. Like, let them roast a little bit longer. Probably another 10 minutes, hopefully, they'll be well done. And I'm gonna cook that like that. Lamb to get done, you always gotta enjoy a glass of my blueberry pomegranate Merlot. Nice fall night. Not too cool. It's cool, but it's not too cool. So, you know, I'm enjoying this weather. This is my kind of weather. Probably be done in another 20 minutes. Because I like them well done, so then I'll enjoy it. Yeah. Pause for a minute, y'all. time is best because there's no mosquitoes. Mosquitoes are going away. That's good. It's getting too cold for them. I'll see that man once, so I'm good. So I guess the wintertime I got my cool crops coming out, which is good. So hopefully they'll grow until November, until our first frost. But like I said, I'm going to grow some peppers in the house because they're really, really good. It's my first year growing my own stuff, so I've never had vegetables that was so fresh, crispy fresh. Even if you cut the salad up, put it in the refrigerator, it'll last for a week and a half, almost 2 weeks. Still fresh. That's all. It don't break down yet because it's super fresh. So I pretty much will always have a garden. It's that good. You know, the vitamins you can build because you're eating fresh. So I love it. Yeah, so those who did some garden this year, you know, shout out to y'all. Those who follow me and also put some crops down. Shout out to y'all because, like I said, if y'all's turned out, it's some of the freshest foods you ever ate. You know what I mean? So I'm always having a garden. It's cool. Until I get my farm, then, you know, I can grow everything. Ready, I'm gonna give y'all, let y'all see the outcome of my grilled lamb and grilled peppers. And a few. I like them well done, so y'all let them simmer on the grill. It got dark, so I don't know if y'all be able to see it. But I'm gonna bring the plate over here in the gazebo where I got a little bit of light and let y'all see. Too bad y'all can't taste it, but y'all at least see the end of the plate. Yeah. So if y'all are new to my page, please hit like, subscribe, and tell me what y'all think, man. This has been a crazy year, 2020. It reminds me it should have been 2012, but you know, this is a crazy year. I never experienced some of the things that happened this year. And we're halfway through it. Thank God. But this COVID thing, what y'all think about that, man? It's crazy. It's affecting 40% of the deaths of blacks. You know what I mean? And it seemed like it was designed for some reason. Like, you know, everything, it's nothing happens in coincidence. Like, all this stuff lining up. You got a crazy ass president, racist ass president. And as soon as he gets in office, he drops all of the our coverage as far as our safety. As far as the CDC and the other agency that Obama created to save us, he cut the budget on it. And it went from 40 people that was watching these viruses and pandemics to 40 people to like 14 people between the two agencies that Obama created. The other one Obama created pretty much to as watchdogs. And they were all over. And when he cut the budget, bam, we get hit with a pandemic. So what y'all think about that? You know, let me know. This is, like, it doesn't add up. You know what I mean? So... And then, you know, the Republicans are pretty much trying to stop, people from voting all across the country. All these red states, they're coming up with all these schemes to block people from voting. He didn't want the mail-in votes. And then, you know, who to say you trust that? You know what I mean? If it opened up, I'm still going in to vote. I'm going in. I ain't stopping you from voting. But I don't know, y'all. America's not looking good for me. You know, I'm ready to see some other places. Probably lay some ground in some other places, some roots in some other places. Because, like I said, I'm not liking what's going on. You know what I mean? I've been dealing with pretty much racism all my life, and it's not stopping. You know what I mean? Especially in the work world, I got out of corporate because every time I turn around, I used to do drafting. I was a drafter, and I went up to design work in different engineering firms, and all the engineering firms use a lot of temps. You know, one of the first companies I worked for, two companies I worked for were black, the first companies. And then from there, it was white. Once I got into white companies, I worked for an agency who sent me to different firms and had me contracting deal with them with different firms. And like I said, it was the same mindset at every firm. It was us against them. Like, hold up, we all here to make money for the company. Why is it you go to a company and it's us against them? Every single firm, it was like that. They got mad when you knew stuff. I had a manager go into the computer, throw all my designs off, and I already printed it out and gave it to an engineer, and he took the designs that he shifted around, took it to the manager and said, look kind of work he does. I already had my work printed out and gave it to the engineer. So me and the engineer went to the main manager. Was like, no, that's not what I did. This is what I did. You know, he was trying to make me look bad. Like, this all, just every firm I went to, tell him, I just got tired of it. Like, the money was good, but I got tired of going through the racism with insecure white men. You know, basically engineers ran by white men, and I got tired of it. It was crazy. You know what I mean? If people, I give it to people that stay in there, hang in there, but you know, I know how to do other things, so I didn't have to sit there and take it with abuse. You come to work, get up. You know, I've pride myself in trying to kill the stereotypes by getting to work early, doing extra work, sometimes staying late. You know, I've had companies where, one of the companies I worked for was out of Columbia. We had the main Verizon contract of doing all the fiber optics in the ground, which gave y'all internet in Maryland. And this firm, it was horrible. When I got there, they were in the red, and I started kicking out drawers so fast, they was loving me. I had two major incidents at this firm. First guy kept telling me, we're gonna hire you, you know, you're doing well, whatever, just keep the work up. So I'm like, cool, you know, kicking out drawings, we were designing fiber optics. And they didn't have room in the electrical side for me, so they moved my desk into the mechanical side. They put my desk right in front, this brand new engineer, mechanical engineer from Milwaukee, I'll never forget. He was a redhead dude. I look up, I'm doing work, you know how you feel somebody staring at you. I look up and look at his office. He just sitting there staring at me. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with him? Why the fuck are you staring at me? You know what I mean? So I'm like, whatever, just keep doing my work. So my manager comes over, like, and this guy comes, it's like day three, this guy coming in. My manager comes to me and say, man, I don't know what's going on, but you know, you're kicking out work, you know, you're getting us out of the red to the blue because he's behind in the contract. He's like, just keep up the good work or whatever. So one of my homegirls did a calendar. Tracy used to own a club downtown. So she gave me the calendar. I put the calendar up under my desk where nobody could see it. It was a swimsuit, somewhat of a swimsuit calendar, but I put it up under the desk so nobody could see it. This dude seen me put up, called my manager, told him that I had naked women out. So my manager showed up at my desk, like, damn, man, I seen the calendar, it ain't naked women, I don't know what's up with this dude, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what dude? He's like, don't even worry about it, just keep doing your work, I'm gonna try to move your desk on the other side. So he's like, just pull the calendar down so I can turn the other side and put it up, you know, you kind of get that. I was like, cool, whatever. So then that put me on guard, like, this guy who kept staring at me in the office was basically trying to get me in trouble for no reason. I never even had a conversation with this guy. So that just goes to show you some of these white men are so insecure with blacks having knowledge and doing different things in different industries that they just attack in any way they can. So with this particular firm, I was there maybe like 7-8 months, but 2 weeks later, the guy, my manager, come over again. He said, man, look, this guy hit the damn nerves, literally. He said, man, maybe try to get you a desk over here. Keep up the good work, man. You're doing good, whatever. So at this point, I know that he just hating on me for no reason, whatever, right? So This was the old five, and this was near the Thanksgiving break. We came to work on a Monday, and then this was the week of Thanksgiving, so we was going to stop, I think, Wednesday. Tuesday came, this dude went on break and never came back. Now, he's a pretty much a high-up engineer, mechanical engineer. So, all of a sudden, word get around the office that he went out on break and had an aneurysm. No doubt. He had an aneurysm out on his break, and one of the veins bust in his head, whatever, and they would say it wasn't looking good or whatever. So, you know, I didn't care anyway, because, you know, he ain't like me, I ain't like you. You know what I mean? So keep it moving. So by I think Wednesday, before we left the office, because the Thanksgiving was on that next day, word had got around the office that he had passed. And I was like, wow, you know, I was like, karma worked fast. Because, you know, it's crazy. He just met me. We never even had a conversation. He hated me, trying to get me fired for no reason. And who knows who else, I mean, other people he did this to. You feel me? Karma worked fast. So, needless to say, they passed the card around from cube to cube, whatever. They gave it to me. I gave it right to the next cube. I'm like, I'm not signing that, man. They were like, you going to the funeral? I'm like, hell no. I'm enjoying my vacation. Peace. See y'all later. You know what I mean? And he passed away. Let me just show you. That's how karma works. You know, don't just be fucking with people for no reason. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'm thinking I had one child at the time or two. And my son was with me. You know, this is my income. You know, why are you trying to get somebody fired for no reason? I don't even have any interaction with you. For you to try to get me fired, you don't have no problem with me, but you just don't hate to see blacks doing what you do, because we got smarts in reality. We created engineering. You know what I mean? The Moors created engineering, created structure, created the first Timbuktu school, where all the Europeans and all that went there to learn from the Moors. You know what I mean? But now they start doing something, all of a sudden they created down on us in here. Get out of here with that bullshit, man. Stop being so insecure, man. And after I left that firm, it's the same way. Every firm is always a hater, and they white, and it's a male. They don't like to see blacks, you know, doing stuff that they do, making money, you know. And the sad part about it is, what firms do in America now, what they do is they hire all their minorities under tip contracts, so you don't have no legs standing. They can treat you any kind of way, and the minute you say something, guess what? They can end your contract that day with no word, no questions. You can't go to EEOC, which is a joke anyway. And the government's not doing nothing like that about it, and I'm just fed up with it. You know, it's horrible. I'm gonna end up writing a book, because all the stuff I experienced at all these different firms, it's just horrible how they do blacks in America, man. It's just crazy. And we not free. Technically, we not free until we got our own. Until you work for yourself, you're not free. But you go to work, you know, and shout out to all the people that go to work and work under that type of stress dealing with crazy-ass white people. You know what I mean? It ain't all of them, but it's enough of them to affect us. You know what I mean? And shout out to y'all, because it's not easy. You gotta take that, and then you got to go home, deal with regular life problems, and here you trying to make a living, and people just giving you a hard time for no fucking reason because you're black. You know what I mean? I worked for another firm where we designed, after 9/11, we started, everybody was buying these huge generators to power their buildings in case the power go out, in case something go wrong again. So I got a job at this firm. Matter of fact, check this out. I sent them my resume with all my qualifications of them, right? I didn't get no call back, no nothing. So I said, let me try something. I sent my resume with a white boy name on it. Don't you know I got called back as soon as they got it and called in for an interview? So I went in for an interview. I think I used his name, Todd. Anyway, once I got there and I gave the guy all my qualifications, and the guy liked me, you know what I mean? So he hired me, you know what I mean? I started designing all these different generators, and the generators were the size of a tractor trailer. So basically that's the scope of what we were designing every day. And they were selling them anywhere from $250,000 on up to $1 million. And they were used for hospitals, different industries who can't do without power. So if something was to ever go down, they got a serious amount of power as backup. And same thing, man. I had this Russian lady. Everything I do, she's calling upstairs. She's calling upstairs. I'm not doing nothing but getting work out. You know, and this was a new gig for me, and this was my first hire. This was my first hire with a white company. After I worked for maybe 20 different firms, it was my first hire with a white company. All the rest of my contracts with in engineering was basically with under temporary work or contract work. This was my first hire, and this Russian lady kept, every time I turn around, she was calling. So every time I go upstairs to turn in, I had dreads at my head at the time. Every time I go to turn in work, go upstairs, it's a guy upstairs who was friends with the VP. Every time I go upstairs, he starts singing Jamaican songs or reggae songs, like he liked reggae songs. And it was real racial, you know what I mean? So I brushed it off and just kept doing my thing. So the VP started being on me. He started getting my work. It was like 7-8 designers. He started picking my work up, going through it with a fine tooth comb. But I was covering my ass anyway, so I made sure all my drawers was tight. So anything he would try to nitpick, he would just bring it to my attention. So all of a sudden I get called upstairs and I get drug tested. I'm like, okay, well, they are drug testing the people that work in the warehouse who actually build the generators, and nobody in the office getting tested. But because I'm black, I'm in the office. It was another black girl in there. But only I was called out to get drug tested. And I was like, man, this is a racist bullshit. You know what I mean? It's like, it was just nonstop. You just keep going through it. When you go from one firm to another firm, it's always the same thing. You just got one or two racist white males there working as insecure, hate to see you making money and give you a hard time. So I eventually just got out, got to my own, started another business, and I've been on my own ever since. But it's just horrible what black people go through in America. And some people just numb to it. They get so used to it that, it don't become a problem to them. And I'm like, well, when is this gonna stop? If I'm dealing with it, my great-grandfather, they were dealing with it, like the same kind of energy. When is it going to stop? And I don't think it is. I'm sorry, y'all not changing. All this marching and all that bullshit, that shit is not working. None of it. So I'm not feeling this place, man. And I never was, and it's crazy. Even the people that act, that the Oreos, that act like they're all black, but they act so white and don't want them to be with black, and they click with white people instead of the other, and they basically turn on black people, like some of these Republicans, black Republicans. You got a racist president that's outright racist, and you still a Republican? Like, how? Where did they do that at? And you'll have no problems with all the stuff that he's saying. He's coming out and literally, he did everything but call him up. And it came out that he have done that, His own family members say he done it. How are you still a Republican? So even if it's for the money, I know people that voted for him because of the money, Nah, it's not worth all that money. You turn on your people just for money. No, it's not worth that. I had a friend of mine, he's white, he asked me, he said, "You really think Trump is racist?" I said, "Man, he's been racist before he ran for president. He put a N or F on people applications. It came out in New York that he was doing that, putting special notes on applications so he wouldn't risk the black people." You feel me? That's racist. That's racist. How do you not figure out he's racist? And this particular guy that's a friend of mine, he basically has a black son. He asked me, he's like, "Man, you think he's gonna rest?" I said, "Hell yeah." And I told him, I said, "Man, that's a slap in your son's face for you to vote for that man, knowing that he's racist. And the energy that he puts out in America is gonna eventually give your son a hard time. That's slapping your own son's face." And I'm just like, this shit is not gonna change, man. So y'all, all y'all, please get your own so you don't have to deal with the bullshit anymore. I know it's like going to work every day and you got people just giving you a hard time just because you're black. You're not allowed to do certain stuff and other people doing it right in your face. Like, come on now. Be fair. Black people don't ask y'all to give us nothing. We just ask for a fair share, a fair shake. You know, that's just how it is, y'all. But hold up, I'm going to check my lamb because I don't want him to burn, but hold up. Yeah, I'm back. So this is the final of the grilled. Y'all can see it, nice and grilled. Green peppers, red peppers, and I also added some mac and cheese and some steamed vegetables that I made inside. But you know, basically this is it. I'm gonna let y'all see it in a second. Let me get it now. So this is the final product, guys. Just to show you, nice. Is this my camera? Nice grilled lamb with roasted peppers, roasted banana peppers, and roasted bell peppers. So you know, just check, you know, let y'all check it out. Got a little skill, so hopefully everything is. I know it tastes good because I made lamb before, but you know, just giving y'all a shot, a little insight of making some fresh, roasted some fresh peppers with lamb. Pretty much, and I'm about to get out, get it in. I'm just giving y'all a shout out. Can't wait to see how it tastes. Mm. That's good, y'all.